I just thought of one more Bob Armstrong story before we get to these reviews, because this was, I wasn't there for it, but it was a famous story in the Georgia locker rooms. And I think I heard it from probably from Frank Morrell when we were down in the, it was either Columbus or Macon. So when we were actually in that building, he told the story. Bullet Bob was fearless, right? A Marine, a firefighter, a bodybuilder, bad to the bone, walked through hell with gasoline britches on, right? Nobody intimidates the Bullet, but he had one weakness. Bullet Bob Armstrong was not fond of snakes.
That's right.
Well, at one point, the guys started doing those the workouts with those rubber tubes, right? The workout tubes. Do people on the street know what I'm talking about? They get this big rubber tube and you stand on it, you do curls and stretch it. It's a warm-up thing, right, that you could carry around in your bag in the locker room. And almost everybody had one of those. And goddamn, one night, I can't even remember who it was. It's probably not germane to the story, and he probably wouldn't want to be outed anyway, but he's got the goddamn coil of the tube. And Bob goes in the bathroom and sits down in the stall to take a shit. And as they wait for a little while, and you could probably either hear or smell when he's in the middle of things, this guy took that, stood up on the toilet next to him and took the fucking coil and threw it over the side of the fucking stall into the stall on top of Bob and yelled snake at the same time. They said it was like somebody had set off a bomb in the middle of the stall. All three of the fucking sides of it, the fucking two sides and the door, blew out at the same time and went skittering around as Bullet Bob Armstrong came with that goddamn thing over the top. He thought a snake had dropped from the ceiling, from the rafters, where, you know, in some of these buildings that could happen. And it was wrapped around his neck, and he's twirling and fighting to get it, and he destroyed the whole bathroom. And finally, when he realized what was on him, then he turned, and the guy that dropped it got out of there, and I think stayed away for a while until Bob had to settle down and realize that it was a funny thing that had happened. But the destruction of that bathroom was due to a rubber coil and Bob Armstrong's dislike of snakes. Well, I guess it was funnier if you were there.
I laughed before. Do I have to laugh again?
Yes, you got to. Every time I say something, you have to keep that smile on your face, Brian.
They say that's why Bob Armstrong thought Jake Roberts was a piece of shit.
Well, I'm sure there were other reasons.